All right, everyone, welcome back to the channel. And if you're new here, my name is Josh Parker, and thank you so very much for joining us. Today's jazz lesson is all about blues, so let's go learn something. All right, so those that are new to the jazz world may not know that much about the blues form, and today we're going to break that down as simple as we possibly can and also discuss some common variations on that form. So the form that we're talking about today is the 12-bar blues, or the 12-measure blues. So the easiest form of this is going to consist of three chords: your one chord in the key, your four chord, and your five chord. Okay, the key that we're going to be discussing this in is in the key of F, and for right now, the biggest thing that we need to know is that all three of these chords are dominant seventh chords. So no major seventh, no minor seventh yet. But for right now, all three of them are dominant seventh. So the first chord that we can have is an F7. It doesn't matter if you play it down here or if you play it up here, just an F7 of some kind. That's your one chord. The four chord is B7. Again, it doesn't matter if you play it down here or up here. And your five chord is C7, which is going to be two frets higher. So now that we know those three chords, the form of the 12-bar blues, your one chord is the first four measures. So you're going to play this for four measures. Then you're going to go to the four chord, which is again B flat, for two measures. Back to the one, F. Then up to the five chord, which is C7. Down to the four. Back to one. For the last two measures. So that totals 12 measures altogether. So again, one chord for four measures. The four chord, two measures, back to the one chord for two measures, so that's eight. And the last four is five, C7, four, B7, one for the last two measures, F7. So that's pretty straight out of the traditional blues, but also the rock blues setting. In jazz, if you want to make it more of your typical jazz sound, we're going to alter it a little bit. So here is the first alteration we're going to do. This is going to be in the last four measures. I'll put up the diagram here so you can see what I'm talking about exactly as well. But the last four measures is where we're really paying attention to right now. So I said before, the last four goes B flat, goes C to B7 to F7. Now in jazz, we're going to change that slightly. So instead of going C7 first, we're going to go to G7, which you could use this standard minor seventh voicing, or you could use a minor ninth voicing, make it even more jazzy, or your minor seventh down here as well. Again, all of those possibilities are open and able to use in any situation here, but we're going to have our two chord, which is G minor, and then your five chord, which is G7, and again, you could use your G13 or your standard G7. To make it more jazz sounding, we can use the 13th, and then to your one chord. So instead of 5-4-1, like you might see in rock or your traditional blues, in a jazz blues, it's always 2-5-1. At the end. Okay, now the next set of variations we're going to do, we're going to add two more chords. So this is going to pertain to the first four measures, and then again those last four measures. So now in measure two, we're going to add an extra four chords. So it'll go a measure of F to a measure of B flat, and then back to two measures of F. The middle four, we're going to leave the same. So again, two measures of B flat, two measures of F, Then we're going to go 2, 5, or G minor to C7 to F again. But then to take us back around, we can play another C7 on the last measure of the form. And that will guide your ear to saying, hey, we're going to keep continuing more of this song or more verses of whatever you're playing, or choruses if you're playing solos, rather than just staying on F for two measures. It can help to add that 5 chord at the very end. Okay, the next thing you can do to keep building onto this theme that we've got going on is we can add more chords to it. So staying on 1 at the beginning, F7. Now we have your 4 chord, B7. But instead of doing it for a full measure, you're going to only do it for 2 beats. And then do an old school trick of playing the flat 5 diminished chord, or a diminished chord a half step higher. So this is a B fully diminished chord. Then that's going to go back to F. So again, F7 for the first measure, B7, B diminished 7, back to F. Then on the second 4, or the middle line here, we're going to go B7, then again that B diminished 7, but this time they both get a full measure. Then again back to F. Then the same last 4, G minor your 2 chord, C7 your 5 chord, F your 1 chord, and then back to 5 again. So with this one, again, just adding the flat 5 diminished, or the diminished chord a half step higher than your 4 chord. In this case, B. So you have F, B flat, B, F. So that first time it's really fast. Second time, B flat for a full measure, and then B diminished for a full measure, and then F7. So again, it's more of an old school thing, but you're doing is you're adding tension and adding movement to the chords. So that's the theme that we're building here, is just adding more and more movement as you go. Okay, so this next series of variations is going to draw more from bebop and adding a lot more 2-5 ones in, again, just to increase that movement that we were just talking about as far as the harmony goes, and to add more complexity and interest as we go as well. So still staying on 1. F chord, then 4. This time I left off the B diminished 7 because we're going to be a little more contemporary. So leave that one off, then back to F. Then here in measure 4, instead of staying on F, we can add a 2-5-1 to B flat, since that's where we're heading in measure 5. So 2 would be C minor. And then 5 would be F7, and then B7. So instead of just staying on F and going directly to B flat, we can go 2-5-1. Then we're going to add that diminished chord again in measure 6, back to F. Then we're going to add another 2-5-1 here in measure 7. So the chord we're going to is G minor. So this time we're going to add a minor 2-5-1 going to G minor. So the 2 in a minor key is going to be half diminished. So in this case it's A half diminished, or A minor 7 flat 5. And then remember the 5 is altered, so we're going to play a D7 with a flat 9, or a sharp 9, or a sharp 5. Really kind of any variation that you want to do that you're hearing, but just some kind of altered dominant chord there. And then that's going to go to 2. So again, in measure 8, half diminished A, or A minor 7 flat 5, to D7 altered, flat 9, sharp 9, whatever you want to choose, to G minor. And then continuing on from there, we're going to go again back to 5 and measure 9. Or excuse me, measure 10. Measure 11, we're going to do a 1-6-2-5. So F, back to D7 flat 9, because we're going to a minor chord, G minor, C7, or 2-5 back to 1. So again, we're just adding a lot more movement. This is how the whole form sounds with these added 2-5s. So F, B flat, back to F, then 2-5 to B flat, C minor, F7, B flat, B diminished, F, then 2-5 to G minor, A half diminished, D7, G minor, C7, F, D7 flat 9, G minor, C7. And that will take you back to the top, or back to F7. Okay, now before we get to learning the heads, there's two more variations of the blues that I want to just very, very briefly discuss. The first one of those is going to be the bird blues, or some people call it a major blues, but this is the blues that's associated mainly with Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie. It's a little different than your standard 12-bar blues that we were just talking about, so you can't just directly translate this unless you're playing with musicians that have really good ears, or you've pre-arranged this ahead of time. But instead of starting on a dominant one, again, we're still an F, you're going to start on a major one. So F major 7. Then you have a series of 2-5s. So it's, the first one is a 2-5 to D minor. So E half diminished, A7 altered to D minor. And then that's going to continue on down. You could play G7 or G altered 7. Doesn't really matter, either one. To C minor 7. To F7. And then finally you're at your 4 chord, and instead of playing dominant, we're again going to play major 4, so B flat major. Then we have another series of 2-5-1s, B flat minor to E flat 7. This time they're going to descend by half step, or by one fret at a time. So next is A minor to D7, A flat minor to D flat 7. Then finally your G minor, your 2 chord. So your 5 chord C. And then finally you get that dominant F7. Then 6, again D7, flat 9, 2, G minor, 5, C7. And then again that will take you back to major 1 at the very top of the form. So with this you have a series of 2-5s. And the rhythm is constantly moving, just like in bebop, or that's the main characteristic of bebop as far as the harmony goes. So again, it's major 1, and then 2-5s by whole step. First one is going to D minor, then down 2-5, D minor to G7, and then down a whole step, C minor to F7. To B flat major, and then 2-5s by half step down to your 2 chord. So B flat minor, E flat 7, A minor 7, D7, A flat minor, D flat 7, G minor, then your 5 chord C7, then finally in measure 11 here, dominant 1 to 6, 2 to 5. Major 1 again at the top. So that one again, it's a little more complex and a little more advanced. We're not going to cover it too much in this video other than what we just did. However, you can add some of these 2-5 movements in your normal blues if you would like to, but at that point it just becomes, how complicated do you want to make it? So that's personal choice, or whoever you're playing with, you can kind of go with them if you hear them doing some of this stuff. How easy do you want it to be, or how difficult do you want it to be? All right, and the last form that we're going to talk about is the minor blues. So it's very similar to the normal 12-bar blues, or the dominant blues that we've been discussing in this video. However, now everything is minor. So instead of F7, you would start on F minor 7. But in this case, we're going to start in C minor for this example, because a lot of minor blueses, you see them in C minor for some reason. But so in this case, C minor is our one chord. And in minor, you don't really usually have so much movement. It's more of like a modal kind of static harmony kind of thing. So in this case, our one chord is going to go for four measures. Then the four chord is going to be F minor. That would be two measures. Back to your one of C minor. And then we're again going to do 2-5-1. However, this time your two chords that half diminished chord, because we're in a minor key. And that's going to be D half diminished to G7 altered, flat 9, sharp 5, whatever alteration you want to do. And then back to your minor 1, C minor. And then again back to your 5 chord to go back to the top. Or sometimes you'll hear people play the flat 6, so A flat 7 to G7, back to 1. So again, in minor blues, one chord, four measures, four chord, two measures, back to minor one, then half diminished two, altered five, back to minor one, and then either flat six, which would be the A flat 7 to G7, or just G7. Or the other option, you could do another fast 2-5-1, so D half diminished to G7 to get you back to the top. So all of those are viable in this case. But again, we're not going to go too far into the minor blues form, but I just wanted to introduce it to you with this video. Okay, so the three heads that we're going to learn, or three melodies, sometimes in jazz you'll hear people refer to a melody as a head, are going to be what's called a riff melody. So this is basically a four measure phrase that is repeated three times to fill out that 12 bar blues form. So the first one we're going to learn is Bag's Groove, which is by Milt Jackson. This one is in the key of F, but there's all kinds of really cool variations on it, and pretty much any key that you want, but we're going to learn it in F. So it's going to start on F, and that's going to start on beat 4. So it's 1 and beat 2. Beat 1 is going to be your C, which is the second string first fret here. So 4, 1, 2, 3. Then we have a series of eighth notes to a quarter note. So B flat, A flat, B flat. A flat, F, A flat, F, E flat, F, E flat. Then again, you're going to play that three times. But that series there, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2 and 3, 4 and 1, 2 and 3, 4. And then again, last measure, you just hold that, or you can mute it, either one. Okay, our second melody is going to be Sonnymoon for Two by Sonny Rollins. So this one is in the key of B flat minor, and again, it's a riff melody, and just like Bag's Groove, it is out of the minor pentatonic scale. I didn't mention that, but a lot of these blues heads are just a minor pentatonic scale, which is what makes them so easy, but also what makes them great. So this one is, again, it's going to be in B flat. And this one also starts on the and of one. So one and it's a B flat to A flat to F to E flat to D flat. And then B flat, A flat, B flat. So that series, you're just descending down the minor pentatonic scale. One. And it's just quarter notes after the end of one till you get to the very end. On beat 4, it's eighth notes. Then you have this little hook. So B flat, D flat, E flat, then back down D flat, B flat. And again, both of those are going to start on beat one, the and of beat one as well. So the whole thing together, we have this. One, three, four, one, two, three, four, and. The blues form in B flat. So the last one here is C Jam Blues by Duke Ellington. And this one is by far the easiest one because it's two notes. It's the note G and the note C. So we have two notes. We have the fifth and the root, which in the key of C is G and the root, C. So you can do it in whatever octave. I have it notated here in the lower octave. But all it is two measures, well, technically two and a half measures of G. It's on beat one, two eighth notes, so da da. Then beats one and three. And then one and the and of two is going to be C. And again, with all riff melodies, you'd play it three times. So one, two, three, four. Three, four, one, three. Four, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, and three, four. Last time, two, three, four. All right, thank you again so very much for watching. I hope you really enjoyed the video. And if you did and you're not subscribed, please click the link down below and subscribe to the channel. So we'll have all kinds of videos like this of lessons and also tone videos and all kinds of cool stuff out in the future. You can also go to my website to get a free PDF of everything we discussed in this video and also in the other previous videos we've done before on my website listed here, www.joshuaparkermusic.com. There's also a link for that down in the description as well. So again, thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. See y'all later.